will be pro kiteboarders. Some of us are going to have a day job. I'd rather be doing this than kiting in Arataki in 35 degrees. But hey, how else am I going to afford new kites? Should call it plumbing life. Living the dream. Pretty light out there, so I've just had to sneak back and grab my 14 meter. Mate, so much for a quick session, but we'll be right back. kiteboardin. Yeah man, it was a bit like that before. I got speeded around too far. The bloody camera smacked into my face. Oh man. It's a wrap for my little session out there tonight at Waikanae Beach. Had a really cool session with a few of the local boys, Stefano, Paul and Andy, if you guys are watching. Yeah, it was super cool, especially as the sun was coming down. We only sort of got 14 or 15 knots, so certainly wasn't mental out there or anything like that. Feels like forever since I've had a good ride out at Waikanae, so yeah, we were basically just fizzing on the fact that we're out there getting some wind. As you saw, I took a few good bales out there today, practicing my Eton Cozzolino strapless air style moves. Man, that guy just makes tricks look so easy. The board just seems to stick to his feet. Whereas when I try a strapless aerial, I go one way, the board goes the other. It's so much harder than it looks when you see the pros on the big screen, basically, yeah, doing their thing. Yeah, every day I'm out there, I'm learning something different. Strapless surfing, when you're going for your aerials, kite position, the way you edge your board off the wave and actually try and get the face of the board into the wave so it glues to your feet. Or like you saw today, I tried to grab the rail a few times, grabbed it once but overshot my board. Second time I missed the grab altogether. In the past I've missed my grab and the board's literally smacked me in the leg. My bollocks have been clobbered a few times. Yeah, this it's just so sketchy. Just so many different fundamentals. If you guys have got any advice for me on my strapless aerials, appreciate the comments below. Man, I'd actually even love to do a clinic. Some sort of wave style clinic would be pretty awesome to get involved with. But yeah, just love the challenge of strapless surfing. For any of you guys with chest mounted GoPros, I don't know about you guys, but man, I took a good knock to the face today by my GoPro. Tried to do a strapless aerial, landed and literally the camera just flicked up and punched me in the face. Got a bit of a fat lip and yeah, it was a bit of a wake up call actually. So it's just one thing to look out for if you guys are going to try chest mount cameras. Yeah, if you take a bale, be prepared to lose some teeth, I reckon. So yeah, probably gonna have to turn the old head or something like that when I take a big bale from a jump or something like that, because yeah, it's like having a flipping boxing glove just sitting there ready to flip and clobber you in the chin. So here in New Zealand, we've got spring on the way in the next few weeks, and with spring brings wind in New Zealand, especially here in the Wellington region. It sort of averages 20 to 30 knots. We quite often get sort of 30 to 40 knot days as well, so really looking forward to that. With the wind, it drives in a lot of swell, so we're going to get a lot bigger waves, which is cool, and also a lot bigger kickers to boost off with some decent wind in our kite to actually hopefully take us up into the clouds and yeah, get some cool footage for you guys. So I'm really looking forward to spring on its way and to make some really cool vlogs for you guys. But until then, catch you next time. Cheers.